عليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته.
My name is Zaki Abdullah. I'm studying third class. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين وآله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد، قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. طلب العلم فريضة على كل مسلم ومسلمة، أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام: My dear respected teachers, parents and my dear Islamic brothers and sisters, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.
Our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, acquisition of knowledge is binding on all Muslims, both men and women, without any discrimination. Narrated by Ibn Majah, the Holy Prophet, blessings and peace be upon him, also said at another place, acquire knowledge even if you may have to go to China for it. Narrated by Al-Bazar in Al-Musnad, he, blessings and peace be upon him, said at another place, Allah Almighty makes the path to paradise reserved for him who walks on it for getting knowledge. Narrated by Muslim, it is apparent from the Holy Quran and Hadith that the acquisition of knowledge is obligated for women in the same way as in the case of men. The study of the life of the Holy Prophet, blessings and peace be upon him, also shows that he himself made special arrangements for the education and training of women. Abu said, Al-Khudri reports that some women said to the Holy Prophet, blessings and peace be upon him, men have gone ahead of us in terms of acquisition of knowledge. Therefore, appoint a special day for them. The Holy Prophet fixed one day for them. He, blessings and peace be upon him, would meet them on that day, advise them and guide them about commandments of Allah Almighty. Narrated by Al-Bukhari, Aisha al-Siddiqa, the mother of the faithful, as a Hadiyan narrator, scholar, intellectual and Jewish of great Shnani. She is believed to have reported 2,210 traditions. Abu Huraira, Abdullah bin Ramana and Anas bin Malik, may Allah be well pleased with them, were the only ones from amongst many Hadiyan narrators who had narrated more traditions than she did. Itself illustrates that women could not only teach men but also men after fulfilling certain preconditions. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.
Wa alaikum assalam.